India has seen tremendous progress in the last 6 decades. Be it in the field of agriculture, service sectors, industries, basic universal education, and global economic growth, India is making rapid strides in progress. But beneath the shining facade of the world's largest democracy is a darker side, where problems galore. A glaring example of this dark side of shining India are the leper colonies at the Bankura District in West Bengal. This self-settled community of sufferers is a far cry from the technology parks and gleaming towers of the progressive metropolitan cities that the country takes pride in. Gouripur Leprosy Hospital. Situated in block number 1 in Bankura District of West Bengal, this hospital is a witness to the stigma attached to the disease and the social and economic isolation it causes. There are so many misconceptions about the disease that leads to social aversion, marginalization, and discrimination against leprosy patients. These leprosy patients were literally abandoned by all, even their own people. So much that even after being fully cured, their relatives continued to despise them and refused to grant them entry into their home and hearth. Shunned by their near and dear ones, these people formed a colony adjacent to this hospital and started residing here. In the course of the realization that blood is not thicker than water, they began to cohabit in a bond of amity and peace. Many years have passed since they formed this colony. Now this colony boasts of 93 residents. These socially ostracized people, till a few years back, lived in abject poverty. To make both ends meet, begging for alms was the only option left to them. Their zest for life began to completely fizzle out. Things began to look up for them since the time the local administration took a firm decision to improve the condition of their lot. It was decided that Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme, in convergence with other related departments for the government, would take steps to improve the condition of 23 families of this colony. As the first step of this convergence initiative, the project of setting up a combined orchard of mango and oranges was undertaken. Permission was obtained from the Gouripur Leprosy Hospital for utilizing the 9 hectares land of the hospital for growing this orchard. Almost 2,250 saplings of Mollica, Amrapali, and Alfonso varieties of mangoes were planted. Also, 450 saplings of Nagpur oranges were planted. The residents of the colony worked in the initiative under the 100 days work. They did not allow their disease to cause any impediment to this noble cause, and they actively participated in growing this orchard. Apart from fruit trees, the orchard also has a provision for growing a variety of vegetables. By growing vegetables like chilies, cabbages, and bitter gourd, these people have found a source of income for the entire year. The orchard is personally supervised by the government officials. They give hands-on training to these people on how to take care of the saplings. Other valuable inputs too are given by them. Not just this, a new community poultry shed is being constructed close to the orchard. Chicks have been supplied by the Department of Animal Resource Development. Residents of this colony, men and women alike, take turns to look after the chicks. By selling the egg and chicken, they managed to fend for themselves. Now let us focus on the allocation of money by each department of the government on the basis of convergence. For infrastructure development of the orchard, 15 lakhs of rupees have been allocated by the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme. The National Horticulture Mission and BRGF have allocated rupees 5 lakhs for the drip irrigation facility, 50,000 rupees for buying seeds and fertilizers for vegetable farming has been allocated by the local panchayat and panchayat shomiti. Community poultry shed is being constructed as MGNREGS has given rupees 1 lakh from their fund. Now is time to analyze how much economically profitable these two schemes are for the residents of this colony. If the Mollika and Amrapali varieties of mango trees bear fruits full scale, 16 metric ton mangoes would be produced every year. The market value of these mangoes would come to around 24 lakh rupees if sold at 20 rupees a kilo. If the Alfonso mango trees have full scale production, around 32 metric ton mangoes would be produced. If these mangoes are sold at rupees 100 per kilo, their market value would come to rupees 32 lakhs. Full-scale production of oranges would lead to an income of around 13 lakh rupees a year. Not only mangoes and oranges, the residents of this colony can earn around 9 lakh rupees every year by the sale of the vegetables produced in this orchard. An additional 20,000 rupees would come from the poultry. Let's now take you to another leprosy colony in the Piyadoba village of Bishnupur block in Bankura. Through a convergence project comprising MGNREGS and other departments, a scheme has been charted for Kushumi lac cultivation. For this purpose, 80,000 saplings of Shemyalota have been planted in the 30-acre land adjacent to this colony. People of this colony take care of these saplings. Rupees 4,85,000 has already been spent from the Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana Fund to set up the drip irrigation system in 10 acres of land. The rest of the 20 acres of land have been irrigated with the help of submersible pumps. Cultivation of lac from the Shemyalota trees has already started. In the current financial year, the residents of this colony have already earned Rs. 2,70,000 from the sale of lac. The residents are hopeful that in the coming years, this number would go up to 7.5 lakh rupees. In their struggle to get rid of the curse of begging that has been haunting their lives, the residents of these two leper colonies have found a friend in MGNREGS. The other departments of the government of West Bengal too have extended their support for their cause.
We will try to dovetail other agency like agri-mechanical, agri-irrigation for their irrigation need day-to-day by way of sprinklers, by way of drip irrigation, and we will try our level best to give them all kind of like manures, organic manures, vermicompost and all.
The main aim and objective of the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act is to economically uplift such vulnerable sections of the society and provide them with a firm ground beneath their feet. The convergence projects of Makura's block number 1 and Bishnupur block are definitely a step forward in this direction.
This is not just planting certain trees, but this is including the excluded. The people who have been affected by leprosy and had been traditionally begging, earning their livelihood through begging, they are now seeing a new ray of hope. So there will be a time will come when they will not have to go outside for begging. They will be able to earn their livelihood from there itself. So this kind of an exercise is very unique And this is a very positive initiative, and we expect that this initiative will positively succeed, and at the same time, this initiative will then be taken forward in other areas as well.
Today, the residents of this leper colony take pride in the work they do. They are brimming with life and enthusiasm towards a brighter future. A future where they would break free from the shackles of being marginalized and live with the dignity of being productive members of the society. For them, this journey from darkness to light has just begun.